quiet, call a lawyer, never say anything to the
Talk
cops.
Radio 790 KBC, you're listening to Karl Gerber, Workplace Lawyer Show. I'm Karl Gerber, I'm a real workplace lawyer, and this is a crazy show. We left off last week in a rather precarious position. We located a brothel that was supposed to be a, was supposed to house or at least provide a lead on where the soldier's genital might be. It turned out the establishment was run by Angel from episode 59. She's the woman who carries around a recycler advertisement from the mid-70s, where her appearance was largely overshadowed by a dog who photobombed the 35mm photography session when he took care of business on a fire hydrant in front of her.
I, Mindy Goldman, that's my married name, am the daughter of the great imposter of Don Rickles. I was forced to try out for step 2 of 12-step in Overprotective Parents Anonymous. I couldn't make contact with my sons for 12 hours, so I tagged along.
Remus Helms gave me the 14-inch self-destructing memory stick that made sexual noises at destruct. I brought the stick to Gerber. It contained a clue. Reverb showed up, and so did my mother, Dr. D. When we were looking for the brothel, my mother asked Mr. Gerber a bizarre question about whether an employer might have to accommodate a woman who suffers from an orgasm disorder where she has to orgasm 180 times a day.
That's not me. I just wanted to run the math in my head and figure out if the woman could take care of all of her business on a 30-minute uninterrupted meal break. The numbers didn't add up.
I decided to come along because Myron Alfumbra, pronounced Madding but spelled Eminem, ruined the life of my husband, Chapstick, who used to manage the world's largest database of sanitary napkin users before Myron, you know who, got into the metal framing at Chapstick's office and downloaded part of the database onto an 8-inch floppy disk. That's episode 46 of this show, to be found on the Karl Gerber with a K channel on YouTube. Oh, I owe the soldier because he escorted my husband and I to North Korea when they thought they had the database and South Korea was going to have to reunify. I think the rest of you forgot to say Myron Alfumbra, pronounced Madding, but spelled Eminem, was holding the soldier's thing hostage in Iraq along with the missiles that the U.S. never found.
Reverb and Starbright said they might want to give it a whirl at being call girls. I was explaining the ropes when Mr. Gerber cut me off and claimed young women aren't naturally bad negotiators.
Well, there was actually a purpose of the show. I mean, after all, the studies are not great. The most reliable one claims male negotiators try to gain a psychological advantage against aggressive females. One tactic is to cast aspersions on the femininity of those individuals because it isn't supposed to be feminine to negotiate.
Reverb and me were just pretending. We were going to infiltrate if it would help get back the soldier's thing. Can I have the microphone for a little while?
Angel, I think you're right. Nobody can put up with that voice.
I was not going to be intimidated. When I was in the army, I learned some men tried to embarrass me if I tried to bargain for the good salamis. They had quinoa. I didn't want the turkey salami. They didn't make me feel self-conscious just because I'm 5 feet and small change.
Oddly, studies have shown that women from the Chinese culture are very good negotiators. Star bright. However, she's not Chinese.
We're gonna get more Chinese girls at my brothel here.
The leading study claims Chinese males may actually be poor negotiators because the trait of negotiating is thought to be feminine in the Chinese culture. I do not think a young Chinese woman raised in China would learn anything from working at your negotiating school, Angel.
Mr. Gerber, have you considered women from cultures lower in individualism, higher in, say, group collectivism practices, lower in assertiveness practices, and higher in harmony? those women are more likely to outperform men in negotiations.
Oh, Dr. D, that is true.
Starlight and I have a lot in common. We dress the same, sound the same, we both disappear, we both make things light up, and we're good negotiators.
Yeah, I'm not terribly impressed with these studies about women in negotiations. I'm not sure how accurate they are, opposed to just being a bunch of generalities.
Mr. Gerber, you can't use the Star Sisters as clinical research subjects in a double-blind human behavioral study. They aren't, typical. One of them claims she was conceived when her mother's thing got together with their father's thing the night of the Northridge earthquake over at some IVF lab. Actually, I was working there at the time, just part-time. During that period, there was a high incident of births to children who, shall we say, belong at the Remus Helms cosplay ostrich ranch. As a young PhD, I wanted to study the phenomena.
At the end of the day, the most comprehensive recent study found overall men only did slightly better in negotiation, but women in countries of low individualism do better in negotiations. In societies that are communal, women do better.
Then are you suggesting women out on the cosplay ostrich ranch, perhaps those sharing the one-mile-long bed of Remus Helms, those competing for the endowment, they would be superior negotiators?
There ain't no question, especially the ones fighting over Remus Helms' endowment. But I can't get any of those women to work here in this bedbug-infested brothel set up in a deserted motel near the old power plant in Redondo Beach that's now a park.
Maybe you could offer girls from the cosplay ostrich ranch perks like their own tent. A lot of young people today prefer the freedom of being homeless and living in a tent. Mm-hmm. Now, Chapstick and I still have the party bus from when he was at the top. But definitely don't downplay maybe starting a brothel in a tent city. One with real good tents. A couple rooms, too.
Starbright does have a point. Apparently, the Lucky Seven Tarzana really took off once they decided to leave up the thin painter's plastic between the rooms. It's more communal. It's a more communal atmosphere. Oh, no, no. I mean, maybe Nizuki read those negotiating studies and figured her neuro-nurses would get better at negotiating with the femme painter's plastic op.
So, Mr. Gerber, are you analyzing or making an analogy between the painter's plastic to a nylon partition in a three-room tent? I just don't know. Nylon is so close to Berber, at least ever-growing Berber that is actually nylon, and plastic is more like a sex toy.
Right, not even a sophisticated sex robot.
The whole purpose of the brothel is to foster something better than a plastic experience.
Madame, you do advocate safe sex, don't you?
I was overhearing the conversation. It's so academic. I couldn't stay outside.
It's bounded authenticity by the time and money.
What in the world are you talking about, Angel?
The girlfriend experience. The girlfriend is the most expensive sex worker. Don't you know anything, Mr. Gerber? Come on.
My pursuit of labor law has generally not allowed me to crawl so deeply into the unauthorized sex trade. I certainly wouldn't mind helping the Labor Commission shut down. Angel, we need all the details before these two candidates, Reverb and Star Bright, can make an educated decision about getting into the life.
This is a waste of time. We're not getting anywhere hearing all this.
What's she talking about?
Oh, she's just hoping the party comes soon.
Yes, the party. The girl is called the party.
Okay, this is the Karl Gerber Workplace Lair Show. We're in a brothel. We're trying to infiltrate it to get information about where the soldier's genital is. This is the weirdest radio show on commercial radio. But if you really want normal legal representation that's going to get you what you want because I can script your case better than anyone else, call me at 877-525-0700 at the office, normal business hours. 877-525-0700 if you want a lawyer that will make the other side's witnesses sound like the guests on my show. 877-525-0700 for the original labor lawyer of Los Angeles. That's me, Karl Gerber. I'm the Karl Gerber Workplace Lawyer Show on Talk Radio 790 KABC. Back in just 1 minute.
And the pudding made of fig.
Message and data rates may apply. TNC and privacy terms can be found at babbel.com/terms. Please don't text and drive.
Have you wanted to speak a new language, but you thought it'd be too hard or take too much time? Then try Babbel for free by texting BEGIN to 64000. In just 15 minutes a day, you'll be on your way to speaking a new language in just a few weeks. And right now, you can try Babbel for free. Babbel starts out teaching you words and phrases by matching them with pictures. You won't believe how easy the interactive program is. Soon the sentences get a little bigger, and before you know it, you're having simulated conversations voiced by native speakers. And because Babbel is crafted by language experts and uses the spaced repetition method, in just 10 to 15 minutes a day, you'll be speaking the language of your choice with real confidence. With Babbel, you can speak a language. Just text BEGIN to 64000 and start your first lesson in the language of your choice for free. Download the Babbel app or text BEGIN to 64000 and try it for free. Text BEGIN to 64000.
Diabetes, high blood pressure, anxiety meds, everyone's on them. If you're a 50-year-old male, maybe a bit beefy, or even with type 2 diabetes, $1 million of term insurance may only cost you about $200 a month. Affordable term life insurance is out there. Call Term Provider and speak with Big Lou at 800-481-1458. 800-481-1458 or visit BigLou.com. Remember, Big Lou's like you. He's on meds too.
From ooh to
aww.
Whatever reaction you're looking for this holiday, spread more joy with holiday cards, calendars, and photo gifts from Vistaprint. And now you can get up to 50% off all holiday cards and calendars at Vistaprint.com. Discover cards in the latest trends or fill a calendar with your favorite photos. So make more merry at Vistaprint.com with up to 50% off all holiday cards and calendars. Plus great deals on photo gifts. Just enter code HOLIDAY50 at checkout. That's Vistaprint.com. Code HOLIDAY50.
Since 1993, the Employment Lawyers Group has been a consistent force in fighting for the rights of California employees. They've represented thousands of employees in cases in which they've lost their jobs, been sexually harassed, discriminated against at work, or owed wages individually or as a group, such as a class action. The Employment Lawyers Group has maintained a high win rate and a serious record before the California courts. Please call 877-525-0700 for an experienced work lawyer. That's 877-525-0700. They have call takers standing by. Online, research the firm at worklawyerca.com. They have offices throughout Southern California. If you hire the Employment Lawyers Group, your legal problem becomes theirs to solve.
Clear thinking. Free discussion. AM 790 KABC.
Be real quiet, call a lawyer, never say anything.
Talk Radio 790 KABC. You're listening to Karl Gerber, Workplace Lawyer Show. We're broadcasting from a brothel near the Redondo Beach Pier where nothing is pancake shaped.
Come on, let's leave and go to Norm's. We can eat pancakes and
sausages. Pork ones.
Do you eat sausages, Mindy?
Of course. I just don't eat the pork. She's poking fun of me. I'm going to get her with my butt.
Reverb, that wasn't very nice. No violence, ladies. I hate to say it, Reverb, but that Mindy has a lethal butt. If I had a different figure, I'd consider having the soldier train me in that defensive mechanism.
Oh, no.
I know when you girls hear from the other girls what they make, you'll be sold.
Maybe. It seems I always get the small end of the money at underground operators. I thought I'd finally be there. I'd be able to quit the job. Semex could retire from the concrete and masonry trade. He'd be able to make concrete sculptures all day long. And then I found out the Cindy D sex robot was one big product liability lawsuit. All those men got stuck.
Remus Helms is a good man. He'd have given you something if it wasn't for the classy action lawsuit. But my friend's barber said she found out from a woman undergoing a reassignment surgery that nobody opted into that class action because they would have to give their names.
Oh, Angel, you've been so hospitable, letting us sit on your bed bug infested sofas while you try to inspire reverb and Starbright to enter the life of prostitution. But I'm just not feeling it.
I'm just not feeling it either.
I think I'd make more if I went out for underwater welding. If I could just get Chapstick out of his depression, the man needs me.
It's gonna be inspiring to hear what the other girls earn. They're coming in now.
I don't see anybody.
Just pretend I'm some cute young thing with a pretty face enough for an ASMR.
I can't.
Oh, whoa, no.
Once you hear how much one of my girls got negotiating the girlfriend experience for a Las Vegas weekend, you will all be inspired to enter the life.
Oh, well, look, Angel, Reverb and Starbright don't really want to sell themselves into the life. We got a tip a certain soldier's thing might be here.
Oh, it was. It was in his bowling bag. But that Myron Alfumbra, pronounced Madden but spelled M&M, came around here last week hoping to get some action for his 3-plug trim customer when he comes to Los Angeles for fundraising. But I told him my girls weren't interested in suing, getting $130,000, then running up big lawyer fees with Dumas once they got sued for defamation. Myron Alfumbra, pronounced Madden but spelled M&M, just went and shipped that thing off somewhere up north when he left.
Are you serious?
Honey, with my agent, do you think I've got time to lie to you?
No! We're up north.
He said he was traveling north with the soldier's genital, and then he made a deal with one of them subcontracting delivery companies for Amazon that was heading north to pick up Christmas toys.
I've been meaning to ask, how come sometimes the 101 freeway says north and sometimes it says south?
Starbright, it even runs east and west depending on where you are.
That's what I mean. It must be the road to perdition. I don't think I'm going to take the party bus on the 101 anymore.
What about the 5 freeway? That goes north, too.
Look, I feel there's so much north the soldier's genital could be located in. Do you suspect it's near one of Gerber's offices up north?
Yeah, if it was in Oxnard, that's north. And I went to his office there and tried to catch stars from the boat dock.
Now, the furthest north I've got is Bakersfield.
Ladies, if I can call all of you that, and gentlemen, the present location of the soldier's thing is a lot further north than Bakersfield.
Fresno! It's in Fresno?
Hardly.
Maybe we can call Remus Helms and get a locate on that object.
That's a good idea, Cindy. Oh, Remus, this is Karl Gerber. Oh, you're listening. Of course you're listening. Do you have a locate on the present position of the soldier's thing?
What's he saying? Saying.
I see, Remus. It's like the Santa tracker. Oh, yeah, I've been involved in that Santa tracking map many years now. I saw Santa in Oxnard in 2011. My older son, well, you know, he's not that interested in that tracking anymore. I don't know if we'll use the Santa tracker this year. I mean, probably we still will.
That's the problem with having a genius. You can't fool Vargene.
Excuse me. Don't say that. A lot of the young, impressionable listeners, they might hear this.
How long is this conversation going to be? I've got a big cloning project at the lab on Monday.
Remus? What? NORAD is now using your technology? Yes, it's the North American Aerospace Defense Command. You're tracking what?
Come on, Mr. Gerber. Everybody knows the Helms Foundation tracks the locations of major genitals.
Oh, that's incredible. I wasn't fully aware of that until now.
Remus, can you give us a locate on the soldier's thing? Yeah, we're still trying to get our hands on it. No, I don't want to touch it. No, I won't. Well, I guess I should start thinking about how we'll transport it if we ever find it.
I'm not afraid of it. I've been in biology since I was a young girl. Bedbugs weren't the first thing I tried to clone.
It's where, Remus? Oh, 6,220.35 miles north of the equator? Well, why can't you just give us an address?
For the metric listeners, that is 10,010.68 kilometers north of the equator.
Where's the equator?
I was never very good in math.
Oh, well, I happen to know the equator passes through Brazil. I imported a container of blue granite, you know, through the equator. Those are the slabs and the tiles we use for the Oxnard office of the Employment Lawyers Group.
I happen to know the North Star is located at about 6,220 miles from the equator.
The bowling bag has moved that far north?
I must say, this is a good thing for the soldier. The average temperature in the North Pole during December is 1 Fahrenheit to negative 16 degrees. I've been a little worried about how that thing might fare if it's not on ice.
Oh, me too.
Well, Dr. D, less than 30% of our listeners are even in the United States. I mean, this is the international comedy show of mass proportion.
As big as Remus Holmes, right?
Well, the number of people who listen on the Karl Gerber with a K channel on YouTube is mind-boggling, but I have to also add that there are 20 other known major sound-sharing sites this rubbish can be heard on.
Oh, I'm sorry. The metric conversion is negative 17.222 Celsius to negative 26.666 Celsius.
I don't know about that. How can 1F be a negative C?
I have to agree. I thought bus sizes only went up.
I thought your daughter was a genius. My Joshy, he's in all honors classes. My Geraldie, he's got a B in psychology this quarter. I swear, that Giselle is the cause. Come to think of it, I better get back to Encino and make sure Geraldie is studying and not locked in his bedroom with that horrible girl. They could be doing unsafe thing.
No, Mrs. Goldman, no more hiding under beds. You haven't been away from your sons for 12 hours yet. How are you ever going to get to step two of your program?
How are we ever going to get to the North Pole?
Now that's the spirit. You'll be away from your sons long enough to make level 3 in your program.
You're all going to the North Pole? It's quite chilly this time of year.
I thought we already covered that. Both metric and U.S.
Yeah, weren't you listening?
You know, I'm just not sure I want to scour the earth looking for that soldier's genital.
Come on, Mr. Gerber. If I can do it, so can you.
I've been thinking that if I come along, then we'll be the Magnificent Seven. Did you know I was the sixth child to be shown in the Mexican village scene in the original movie? People used to always come up to me and ask how it was working with Steve McQueen.
Angel, that movie was shot in 1960. I thought you were 59.
I am.
Oh, man, weren't you a baby?
An infant. I was all wrapped up in a blanket a Russian woman who was supposed to be Mexican was holding. They weren't on a mission to cast real minorities back then. You know, you could barely see my face, just my eyes.
And people recognized your cute little baby face? I mean, your eyes.
I wasn't prematurely aging back then. That was before the booze, before the drugs, before the men, before the cult. I was only a few months old. All I was doing was inhaling my parents' cigarette smoke.
That's awful. This is a Karl Gerber Workplace Lawyer Show. It's unquestionably the strangest show on commercial radio. That's why more and more people listen to it every week. But I originally got involved in this show because I thought I was going to get lots of new clients off this show, and I kind of still hope that happens. So maybe you'll be kind and call me at the office during normal business hours, 877-525-0700. I really am licensed in 4 states, including California. 877-525-0700 for maybe the funniest funniest employment lawyer out there. 877-525-0700 for the original employment lawyer. You know, I was really one of the original ones 26 years ago in L.A. I was the only one in the phone book in L.A., the only one in the phone book in the Valley, too. So keep listening to the Karl Gerber Workplace Lawyer Show on the Karl Gerber with K channel if you want to catch up. That's the easiest place. Or workplacelawyer.org that has all of the episodes chronologically listed on there, because you might want to catch up on this strange tale of finding the soldier's genital and who all these weird voices are. This is Talk Radio 790 KBC. We'll be back in just a minute.
The goose is on the table and the pudding made of
AM 790
KABC. Talk Radio 790 KABC News Update. I'm Steve Cumming. It's going to be a busy week on Capitol Hill. The House is expected to tackle impeachment, government funding, and international trade. On Tuesday, the House is expected to vote on an agreement that will avoid a government shutdown and keep the government funded for the rest of the fiscal year. That will come on the same day the House will draw up rules for the floor debate of two articles of impeachment against President Trump. It's expected to vote on those articles Wednesday. Actress Lori Loughlin and her husband say prosecutors hid evidence in the massive college admissions scandal. She and her husband, Massimo Giannulli, are charged with paying $500,000 to get their daughters into USC. However, they claim prosecutors haven't turned over evidence showing they thought their cash was going to a legitimate cause. The couple has pleaded not guilty to charges that include fraud and bribery. KABC SoCal weather mostly clear tonight with lows in the 40s to around 50. More news coming up in 30 minutes, continuing coverage at KABC.com. I'm Steve Cumming, Talk Radio 790, KABC News.
The choice of a lawyer is an important decision and should not be based solely upon advertising. This ad is sponsored by Case Legal Media. Attention! This is an important message for anyone that has been diagnosed with cancer after being exposed to Roundup or other weed killers. The Internal Agency for Research on Cancer warned that overexposure to Roundup and other weed killers may increase the risk of developing non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Monsanto, the manufacturer of Roundup, may have known that Roundup and other weed killers were likely linked to organ damage and cancer. This information was hidden from the public as proprietary trade secret since 1981, and Monsanto may have failed to warn of the potential risk of cancer. If you or a loved one has been diagnosed with cancer after being exposed to Roundup or other weed killers, you may be entitled to significant compensation. Call us now at 800-912-6114. Our network of attorneys are ready to fight for you. You'll pay nothing unless there's a recovery in your favor. Call now for a free consultation at 800-912-6114. You must protect your legal rights. Call 800-912-6114. Again, 800-912-6114.
Hey, it's Jillian. If you have missing or loose teeth, covering up your teeth when you smile, or don't want the hassle of dentures, dental implants may be for you. Look it for the holidays and get a $1,500 gift voucher for new teeth in a day. Cutting Dental will work with you to determine the best size and shape and color of your teeth so that they look beautiful and natural. They'll put you to sleep, and in one day, you'll have your custom-made smile. Call now and get that $1,500 gift voucher on qualified treatments. 855-9-CUNNING. That's 855-9-CUNNING.
Since 1993, the Employment Lawyers Group has been a results-oriented law firm whose goal is to get the client what they deserve. They've represented thousands of California employees who've lost their jobs, been sexually harassed, subjected to employment discrimination, or were owed wages on an individualized or group basis, such as a class action. They have a high rate of success. There are few situations involving employment law that they have not confronted. At the forefront of employee rights, they're often the first employee law firm to confront a new legal issue. For an experienced employment lawyer, call 877-525-0700. That's 877-525-0700. They have call takers standing by. Online, read more about the firm at employeelawca.com. They have offices throughout Southern California. Make your work problem theirs to solve.
No BS. Constitutionally guaranteed. AM 790 KABC.
Real quiet, call a lawyer, never say
Talk Radio 790 KBC. You're listening to Karl Gerber, workplace lawyer, show on Talk Radio 790 KBC. I'm Karl Gerber. I'm a real workplace lawyer. And hell, you know, I'm about to head north with a crazy group of people on this never-ending quest to find the soldier's genital. You know, Angel, it's all the same to me whether we have seven and we're the Magnificent Seven, or six when we go north, or even one. Why don't we just find a sled and make our way to the North Pole? This is crazy.
never knew the mystery van would make it across the ocean.
I'm a little concerned about driving it on ice. With all of you, we weigh at least 8,000 pounds.
Are you suggesting most of the weight is mine?
No, Mr. Gerber, with Mindy, I reckon we're more than 8,000 pounds.
According to my navigation skills, the navigation mode isn't actually working here on this van. It's a good thing I've had so much experience with offshore sailing. I mean, hell, I boarded a French sailboat offshore in 2000. I took possession of it and sailed it along the coast to the 90-day yacht club in Ensenada.
What exactly is your point?
We're here where we're supposed to be.
There's nothing here, and I am hungry. It's been way more than 12 hours since I've communicated with my sons. I really need to call them. Things could be happening on their computers, in their bedrooms.
We're without a cell signal here, and it's getting dark.
I'll light up the skies. I see a sprawling commune up there in the hills. I used to live on a commune before I was dating the guy who used to wrestle alligators.
Maybe they've got a landline up there.
The latest measurement tends to indicate that commune is in the hills up there. It's 6,220.35 miles north of the equator.
And we're heading towards the hills, and I'll see if I can recruit any talent for my brothel. Since they're living in a commune, they'll be good negotiators.
Ha! Huh. Well, I'll be damned. You didn't happen to live in Southern Van Nuys like me, did you, Angel? What? Who's calling my daughter's hoes?
Yeah, that bellowing is really obnoxious. I'd be grateful to be back in Encino where it's peace and quiet except for the faint sounds of the 405 freeway from Royal Oaks. Lisa Glickman should have told us the gates don't keep out the sound.
The signpost up ahead says, "Welcome to Lapland."
Maybe this is a fatty farm. When I was little, my dad sent my mother to a health farm in upstate New York. It didn't do any good.
Oh, this place looks like a winter wonderland.
I'm pretty sure I could eat that gingerbread house. I just need to find a way to clear the snow off the roof. Maybe I could suck it up. Could anybody help? Cindy D? Reverb?
I don't know. This looks like one big environmental hazard. There's billowing smoke from all of those chimneys. Like, haven't these people heard of pollution? Like, maybe using natural gas?
Yeah. I'd have to agree. If I breathe in any more CO2, I might start looking like I'm 80.
Oh, dearie, you already do.
Since you were able to take off your face, Dr. D, maybe you can get Angel a new face for Christmas.
Oh, no, it is impossible. It wouldn't stick. She's too far gone.
I tell ya, I only smoked 3 packs a day at my height. 8 beers, hard alcohol, probosibin too. I didn't even do the hard stuff.
Look, there are these cutesy little short guys with big noses walking out of that wooden boomerang factory.
I believe those species are elves. Have you seen an elf before, Cindy?
Lots of times. Not just doing mushrooms, either.
I've been wondering, do a lot of elves call up for those landline phone sex calls?
Let's storm this place. Go up to whoever's in charge, serve them with a lawsuit, and order that they give back the soldiers' genitals, elves or not.
Wow! Are you Karl Gerber, workplace lawyer, in that big oversized van? We tried to organize, but he said that wasn't the spirit. We couldn't get a union in here. We sure need your help.
Elf maid? I'm not licensed in these parts.
Well, nobody's licensed around here. They just go around treating us like slaves, getting us to make all sorts of handmade toys, wrap lots of useless plastic stuff they make in the factory. Plastic! Do you know what that's done to our lungs?
Tell me about it. After my residuals for the 3 bewitch pots ran out, I had to burn all my daughter's Barbies so we wouldn't freeze one Christmas. And then when I was freebasing, I used to heat it up in the microwave in plastic pipes for blowing bubbles. When that plastic melted as I inhaled, it sure did a number on my lungs. Probably aged me like 15 years.
Elf Maid, I'd like to assist you in a potential revolt against your evil employer, or at least help you unionize, but I'm actually here on a mission to find Sergeant Friday's genital. Remus Helms' genital tracker located in these here parts.
Myron Alfumba pronounced Madding, but spelled M&M left in a sleigh last week. I'm pretty sure that's what you're looking for was in that big wooden crate our master made. The master carpenter built in exchange for a bowl of watery soup. There's no way to pay a worker.
Your master is in on this?
Oh, he's not a very bright man. Too jolly for his own good. I think he got duped by Myron Alfumba pronounced Madding but spelled M&M. You know, our master doesn't have much hair.
Did Myron Alfumba pronounce Madding but spelled M&M come around here trying to hawk his ever-growing Gerber toupees that are actually nylon?
Yes, sir! Our master got the green and red one. It's retailing for $12,000 in the United States. He said he doesn't need his red and white cap anymore.
Oh, the green and white ever-growing Gerber toupee that's actually nylon? Now that's a very seasonable model. A lot of the Johns have been wearing it lately. Wasn't it the number one purchase on Cyber Monday?
I just don't see how a green and red toupee works in Redondo Beach. I mean, it's like, it's more Christmas.
He's right. I'd rather suspect the Johns in the Redondo Beach vicinity would fancy goatees and ever-growing surfer wigs.
Yeah.
Well, since the soldier thing isn't here, I guess we'll be leaving.
Amen. Now I can get back to my sons. For all I know, my Geraldie could be married to that awful girl by now.
I thought you were the Magnificent Seven. Aren't you going to stick around and free us from our chains?
Oh, this is a conservative talk radio station. We can't be talking like that.
Come on, Mr. Gerber. Are you an employee lawyer or not?
Yeah, Mr. Gerber. Don't chicken out just because most of the Magnificent Seven gets killed in the movie. Do you think I look like James Coburn?
You're 5 feet tall and look like Tinkerbell.
I don't know if you'll have to fight. Our master is a very peaceful man, just sort of outdated in his notions. The kids don't want these physical toys anymore. He just can't make ends meet on wooden boomerangs and rocking horses.
Oh, most kids today want mechanical bulls. All they need is a phone camera, and they can shoot their own YouTube video.
Things were better when the missus was still around.
Well, where is she now?
The last I heard, she was training to be a Nuru nurse. She got really inspired by one of Nazuki Nuru nurses talking about how much she made working at the Lucky Seven Blythe. It's a much warmer climate there. Better for the Mrs. Arthritis.
Do you know if she went out for regular clinic work or driving for the app? I've heard the Blythe Clinic is a little slow, and the masseuses who work the app out there have a gigantic region they have to cover.
I've got to travel all around this workshop, and nobody reimburses me for having to feed my reindeer.
Oh, I definitely think you should sue for expenses. With your voice, maybe I could get you into ASMR.
No!
There's a big demand for whispering the way you sound.
Wow! Could I go back to Hollywood with you? Mr. Gerber, do you think you'd be able to negotiate an employee contract for me? I get residuals and commissions.
Oh, listeners, this raises a very interesting question. What is really going on here? I mean, we're coming to this enchanted wonderland looking for the soldier's genital, and we find out it just left as we arrived, and what is this all about? This is weird. This is the Karl Gerber Workplace Lawyer Show, and I actually am a real workplace lawyer, and I am hoping that you call me and hire me to represent you on a case against your evil employer. Maybe they're as evil as Myron Alfumba pronounced Madding, but spelled M&M. If that's the case, Call me at 877-525-0700. 877-525-0700. I can't guarantee that Reverb or Cindy D will be hanging out in my office, but they might just be. 877-525-0700 for the employment lawyer that has been known to come up with the craziest cases and some of the best cases too. So this show is an ongoing saga, as you might have realized. This is actually episode 87. I'd encourage you to go to workplacelawyer.org. That site has all the episodes on it. Numerically, you can find them. You might want to catch up. Maybe you've heard some of these voices before. Maybe you haven't. We've got a collection of voices in the studio tonight, and it's going to be like this for a little while now because it seems to be getting more and more people interested in the show. And there is a little bit of political and social commentary going on here besides labor law too. So we'll be back to hear more about what's going on in this winter wonderland when we return to the Karl Gerber Workplace Lawyer Show on Talk Radio 790 KBC.
You can say there's no such thing as Santa.
Since 1993, the Employment Lawyers Group has been a results-oriented law firm whose goal is to get the client what they deserve. They've represented thousands of California employees who've lost their jobs, been sexually harassed, subjected to employment discrimination, or were owed wages on an individualized or group basis, such as a class action. They have a high rate of success. There are few situations involving employment law that they have not confronted. At the forefront of employee rights, they're often the first employee law firm to confront a new legal issue. For an experienced employment lawyer, call 877-525-0700. That's 877-525-0700. They have call takers standing by. Online, read more about the firm at employeelawca.com. They have offices throughout Southern California. Make your work problem theirs to solve.
Thinking about life insurance? Did you know in just a few minutes you can find the best price from up to 10 price competitive companies for free? You can with SelectQuote. For example, George is 39. He was getting sky-high quotes from other companies because he takes meds to control his blood pressure. But when I shopped around, I found him a 10-year, $500,000 policy for under $22 a month. I'm SelectQuote agent Dan Savino, and believe me, if SelectQuote isn't shopping for your life insurance, you're probably paying too much.
For your free quote, call 800-509-7152. That's 800-509-7152. 800-509-7152. Or go to SelectQuote.com. Since 1985, we shop, you save.
Get full details on the example policy at SelectQuote.com/commercials. Your price could vary depending on your health, issuing company, and other factors. Not available in all states.
Want to know the sneaky way to give the perfect gift this holiday season? Just tiptoe into your loved one's closets and look at their shoe sizes. Then head to Skechers and make this holiday the most comfortable ever. Because at Skechers, we have ultra-comfy, ultra-affordable shoes you can buy everybody you know. Let's start with the kids. We have stretch fit, shoes that light up, and many more. And how about for mom, dad, and even the grandparents? We've got boots, sneakers, slip-ons, and so much more. Find Skechers at Skechers.com, at a Skechers store near you, or wherever stylish shoes are sold.
When you're diagnosed with metastatic breast cancer,
a million questions flood your mind.
How can this be happening?
Am I going to be able to work?
What's a subtype?
What do I do now?
We know.
We went through it too.
But once you start to understand your options,
you can partner with your doctor
and find ways to face MBC on your own terms.
Visit findyourmbcvoice.com and learn how to speak up and have a more informed conversation with your doctor.
Some questions have answers.
Visit findyourmbcvoice.com to find some of yours.
The proud home of Ben Shapiro. Weekdays, 3 to 6 a.m. 790 KABC.
A lawyer never say anything to the cops.
Talk Radio 790 KBC. You're listening to Karl Gerber Workplace Lawyer Show. I'm Karl Gerber. I'm a real workplace lawyer, but I'm in a winter wonderland with a bunch of weirdos looking for a soldier's genital.
Maybe I could stay here and be the missus. I look old enough to have arthritis. Actually, I do have it. It probably came from all that waving I did back in 1968 when I rode in back of the convertible at the Hollywood Christmas parade.
I hate Christmas!
I hate genes that can't be cloned.
Well, we're on the subject. I hate uncollectible defendants. Those small employers commit all the employment torts, and then they change your name when you win. They go out of business or just don't pay because they say they don't have it.
Look, Mr. Gerber, you can see this is a big outfit here. Lots of cute, low-slung buildings, too. I'm sure somebody would buy them for a lot of money in Hancock Park, anywhere in L.A., and knock them down so they could build something massive and white. I'm pretty sure you'd be able to collect. They have all sorts of things here.
There's just one thing we're looking for.
It looks like all they've got here are a bunch of children's toys nobody wants anymore. I don't think I'd want to fill the big van with physical children's toys and try to resell them back in Los Angeles.
Mr. Gerber, have you represented seasonal workers?
Have I heard of Santa Claus? Do I know my state bar number? What kind of a question is that?
Good, good. Since you know who he is, then you know he's a collectible employer.
Wait! I'm gonna sue Santa Claus?
Well, this show has taken on a rather depraved nature. The new room nurses, phone sex operators, although she's my daughter.
What about the whisper porn legend who causes orgasms with only her voice? Voice.
Reverb, although we're very happy when we remember you, you can't possibly be my biological daughter. I donated my uterus to science before you were born. You just appeared one morning in the house.
That happens all the time around here. How do you think Santa gets all the workers?
Ooh, elves donate their uteruses to science?
Elves just appear.
You get them from advertisements? Maybe Craigslist? Indeed.com?
Glassdoor, too. I heard that awful woman noob from episode 83 got her first job at 30 off Glassdoor.
It isn't exactly like a revolving door you can see through around here.
More like thin painter's plastic you can see through.
Okay, I'll stand up for what's morally right. Elf maid, how are you paid around here?
At first he was paying us in mirth. Mirth! Can you believe it? I can't buy cute pointy caps with mirth.
Well, how are you paid now?
Piece rate.
Employees in the manufacturing business can't be paid by the piece.
Yeah, but he's not basing overtime on the sums derived from piece rates during my normal 40 hours a week.
Well, how's he doing it?
He isn't. That's why Mrs. Santa left the commune.
I find this to be religious discrimination. I don't see any blue and white around here. Do you, Mr. Gerber? Why aren't they making Hanukkah toys?
Oh, I think they are. I'm just not sure how they get distributed.
They're subcontracting these days.
Well, just for the Hanukkah toys? I mean, now I am offended. I don't think that the children celebrating Hanukkah should be left for mediocre subcontracted delivery services.
All delivery services have been subcontracted since Amazon took over.
Is Santa going through Amazon now? God, that takes all the holiday spirit away. Even if my 8-year-old daughter still played with toys, I don't know. Maybe not get her a landline. You really don't want to be giving her ideas, Cindy.
Yeah, I have to get back to the studio. I've got a Christmas recording all planned out for me.
Oh, heavens!
Gee, I mean, we just came here trying to find the soldier's genital, and we've chanced upon all of these labor and societal issues.
As much as I'd like to stick around trying to solve the dilemma of Santa's subcontracting of delivery, I've got reproductive body parts to clone back in Thousand Oaks.
Gosh, Mom, you're just gonna leave us like this?
I've been wondering, what if I brought a little, of holiday mirth to all the elves and Santa? Will it work on them?
Now, Reverb, that is very inappropriate.
Dr. D, if you leave, we won't be the Magnificent Seven anymore.
Oh, but Angel, if she leaves and the Elf Maiden joins us, we'll still be seven.
What are we gonna do? Storm the workshop and free the elves?
As I understand things, large corporations in Australia have to teach their workers about the perils of slavery. Not that these companies are engaging in slavery, maybe just to make sure that they're politicizing their workers, getting them informed of their rights, their workplace rights. Well, you know, maybe we could just help Santa write an employee manual or something while we're here.
I hardly think that's enough. I want overtime based upon my weekly piece totals. We need regular 10-minute rest breaks. It's hard work slaving over the conveyor belt.
I vote for rules about workplace dress. You're all dressing like a bunch of creatures out of a white person's late 19th century fairy tale. A lot of women your age are wearing yoga pants these days. You might like them.
Yeah, you elf maidens shouldn't have to cover your heads.
Well, they might be orthodox, are they?
No, Mindy, I'm afraid this is largely a Christian-themed work camp.
Well, then the elves should have freedom of religion. What if they want to celebrate Kwanzaa instead of Christmas?
Yes, ma'am! I've been reading a lot about the Jehovah's Witness. I think I'm ready for that. They don't celebrate Christmas.
Well, in other ways, Elf Maiden, are you thinking that if you converted, maybe you wouldn't have to work here because that would, contradict your religious beliefs?
I'd do anything to get out of here. Do you think they'd take me on at the Remus Helms Cosplay Ostrich Ranch? Do you think I'd fit in?
Yes!
Oh, yeah.
What about the reindeers? He says it's just a seasonal job for them, so they should be grateful.
Which raises the question, what do the reindeers do the rest of the year?
They hibernate in the barns. He says the rent credit for a year around housing, for year-round housing, more than makes up for their work.
Is Santa charging the reindeers more than the prescribed maximum rent credits allowed by statute? And furthermore, why isn't he paying them minimum wage?
Oh, nobody gets minimum wage around here. If only we lived in California, we'd be making $14.25 an hour in Los Angeles County, because there are more than 25 of us.
This is a really stupid discussion. Minimum wage laws don't apply to reindeers.
I beg to differ.
Who knows where the soldier's genital will take us next? Will we stick around in Santa's village and try to bring his workforce up to 2020 standards? Will we get another lead or...
I've got a shift back at Underground Operators.
Where did Reverb go?
She disappeared again. Maybe she's gonna go do some ASMR stuff from the North Pole for a while.
This program has been made possible through a generous grant from the Helms Foundation, $5.14 billion in funding, and 14 inches of endowment. We strive to bring you the strangest content on any commercial radio station. Whether or not it relates to labor law, we really don't care. But we do tend to discuss labor law in these shows and extremely controversial radical notions like organizing Santa's workforce and the whole subject matter of that subcontracted out shipping of Christmas toys. Would you rather the Christmas toys were shipped out on a sleigh or in a UPS van? Well, that time of year is coming, Christmas and Hanukkah, and I certainly hope that everyone is caught enough PTO days to make it through the holidays when they call in sick literally every day. I mean, yeah, this time here at the office at the Employment Lawyers Group, I just can't help it. I come to work, but my staff, a lot of them don't show up. So yeah, you're going to get me if you call on the phone. And please don't just screw around with me. Some people call in and say, oh, Starbright referred me and they want to make jokes. But at the office, it's a very serious environment. And that's for real because we are representing individuals with real labor problems. And that is to be taken seriously. So if you want to call about a real labor problem, 877-525-0700. if you're an employee, 877-525-0700. If you want to sue your employer because you lost your job, because you have unpaid wages, sexual or racial harassment, or maybe even a work injury. We don't get into cases and there is no job loss. A lot of times, if the person's just having a lot of problems at work, that's not something the courts actually look at, whether you're in Santa's Village or the United States. The courts are for situations where employment has been severed, there have been awful comments made about someone's religion or their sex or something like that. So 877-525-0700, their normal business hours, will actually get you through to the Employment Lawyers Group. We have 15 offices in California, and I am the head of the law firm, and I guarantee you that if you hire me, your lawsuit will be scripted differently than the way the other lawyers would do it. And the judges will actually read the briefs, the other side will, and it may win your case. So again, this is the Karl Gerber Workplace Lawyer Show, Talk Radio 790 KABC. Come next week. We'll be back during the week. I hope no workplace abuse, but if there is, I think you know where to call.
But as for me and Grandpa, we believe.
This show furnished by Karl Gerber and Employment Lawyers.